Hey guys, I'm Eric Bidelman. I'm a staff developer relations engineer working on Polymer at Google. So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about how you can use Polymer and web components to interact with some of Google's most popular APIs and services just by writing a little bit of HTML. You know, the other day I was thinking, how many APIs does Google have? Do you know? I actually didn't. I had to do my research on this one. So it's over 250 APIs, things like Google Maps and Google Drive, spreadsheets, calendar, analytics, you name it, Google's probably got it. And of course, we all know that creating complex web applications requires you to interact with APIs and services. So on the Polymer team, we've been thinking about this a little bit. How do you combine Google's awesomeness with the world of web components? We really want to make working with web components as easy as writing a little bit of HTML. That's really the power of web components. And it turns out they're a great delivery vehicle for wrapping existing content, libraries, and services. Think of it as a way to declaratively provide a declarative surface area for the API that exists. This is really where Polymer comes in. For those that don't know, Polymer is a bleeding edge technology. It's a library built for the web and allows you to create web applications based on web components. But to me, what Polymer really does is provide a thin layer of opinionated layer on top of the web component APIs. So we built in things like data binding, property observation, gesture support, mobile support. These are really important when you're building applications. We want to make it easier for you to ramp up and use. So we built that into Polymer itself. You know, a popular API is something like Google Maps. It's very complex. It's very rich. So let's take a look at how web components can actually make your life easier using that API. This is Google Maps Hello World, right? It's pretty simple, but there's a little bit of boilerplate code that you have to write every time you want to render just a map to your page. You have to know to style it using a little bit of CSS. You have to know that there's a container div that you need to create. You have to load the library. You have to remember that. You have to work with loading and callbacks and write a little bit of JavaScript. Point is, there's a lot of process you have to go through to get this thing kicking. So let's see what we can do with web components. In the world of web components, this is the Google Maps API. It's a single tag you declare on your page. That's ridiculous. Ridiculously awesome. You declare it and you're off to the races. And it does exactly what you expect, which is render a map to your page. It's simple, it's declarative, it's intuitive. I don't have to write JavaScript code. I don't have to know about callbacks. I don't have to read API documentation. You get my point. You just use this thing and it works. But Google Maps, right, is an extremely complex API. So instead of writing JavaScript, what we can do in the world of web components is expose attributes on this element for people to configure the different properties and methods that the API exposes. So for instance, really common thing to do, latitude and longitude set the center of the map. We can do that now using that latitude and longitude attributes. We can also set the zoom level of this map just by setting the zoom attribute to 15. That's really awesome. Again, it's all declarative and super intuitive. You can read this code and know what's going on. And adding markers is just as easy. It's just as declarative. So we can drop in a bunch of Google Map marker elements inside of the Google Map tag itself and compose these in different ways. The fact that the marker tag is in the map is significant. It knows to render that marker to the page. I'm also reusing other parts of the platform here. So you notice I didn't reinvent the wheel for the title attribute, or I didn't reinvent the wheel for the drag and drop API. I'm using the draggable true attribute. So again, I can reuse parts of the web platform that already exist. I don't have to reinvent that wheel every time I start a new project. That's cool. The other thing I really love about this element is that it makes some of the API complexity go away. So one thing that's really common to do in the world of maps is center your map inside of the viewport of all the markers that contained inside of it, right? Make sure they're available to the users at all times. That's a little bit of boilerplate code, a little bit of JavaScript that you have to know how to write every time you want to do that. You add a new marker, you want to update the map. Instead, what we can do in the world of web components is, again, expose another attribute, this fit to markers attribute. So as long as I have that on my marker tag, my map tag, boom, the map just updates itself. It knows to set the zoom property accordingly. That's Google Maps. It's super declarative, super easy to use. But you can imagine a ton of other use cases here for all the APIs Google has, whether it's working with charts or spreadsheets, analytics. Anything can be a web component. We can provide a declarative surface for people to tap into that. And that's exactly what we've done. So we've been experimenting with this over on GitHub. If you want to check it out, Google Web Components is the GitHub organization. We have a growing collection of awesome components there, things for analytics and maps you saw, Google Spreadsheets. We also have base components for doing more low-level things, working with the libraries that Google has, doing OAuth 2. God knows that is very complex. So just like Maps, these are super declarative, super easy to use. Check them out. If anything is missing, let us know. We're really interested in getting your feedback, getting pull requests, and adding new APIs and services all the time. So actually, let's use this. Let's combine proof in the pudding, create an application that uses Google Maps and Google Spreadsheets. We'll create a Polymer element that wraps all that together, and that users can use that element inside of their own applications. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. We're not going to write any JavaScript to do this. We're just going to write a little bit of HTML. So if you're curious, this data is going to be coming from a Google spreadsheet. This is what the data actually looks like. Essentially, it's just a list of businesses in Portland, Oregon. Right? There's a little bit of metadata. But the most important thing here is that we have the latitude and longitude columns. This is the data that's going to render those marker objects. So the first thing we do, we got to bring this stuff locally into our app. We're going to use Bower to install it. We're going to Bower install the Google Map tag. And then you see the example here, which we've already seen. So let's move on. What you haven't seen is the Google Sheets tag. This is an element for working with Google Spreadsheets. We're also going to Bower install that, bring it in locally to our application. And the second example here is how you actually use this element. So again, it's super declarative. I declare Google Sheets, and boom, I'm off to the races. It's got a publish property, which essentially means, hey, this data is being published publicly. Don't worry about doing authentication. It's just there. GID corresponds to the tab in the spreadsheet that I want to interact with. So GID 0, first tab. And the last thing we're doing is providing a spreadsheet key. And you see the example here. Where you actually get the key is in the URL bar when viewing this spreadsheet in Google Docs. So it's super easy to use. And the last step, if you're outside of Polymer, you just have to write a little bit of JavaScript to maybe listen for the event that this element fires and then react accordingly. So in this case, we can print out the data that the spreadsheet returned. But it's really that easy. Declare, go. So now that we have those dependencies installed, right, Google Maps and Sheets, let's actually use them. Let's create a Polymer element that wraps that functionality together. This is the entirety of the application. Let's walk through these pieces. So the first thing, now that we have the dependencies installed, you want to list them at the top of your file. So this is using HTML imports, which is one of the web component APIs. We're going to list Polymer as a dependency, the Google Sheets as a dependency, and Google Maps as a dependency, now that they're in our application. The second thing we're going to do is create a Polymer element. So this is using Polymer's declarative sugaring to do this. The name of the tag we're going to create is map-sheets. This is what somebody's actually going to declare on their page when they use our stuff. The second thing you see here is this NoScript attribute. That's essentially just a hint to Polymer to say, hey, you know, I'm not going to add any properties, any methods to this. It's just going to be a little bit of markup that we're essentially repackaging for users. So it's a pretty simple element. Inside the elements template, you're going to drop in that Google Sheets component. This is what's going to talk to our spreadsheet. You can see I got the key there. I got that publish attribute. And we're data binding to the rows attribute that this thing has on it. More on that in just a second. Right below it, we have the Google Map Sheet. This is your friendly tag that we already know about. Notice that we're using that fit to markers attribute that we talked about before. So again, anytime I have extra markers being rendered in this map, it's just going to know to set the zoom level to the appropriate level. Lastly, what we're doing is we're using Polymer's declarative data binding features to declaratively loop over the row data returned in the spreadsheet. So again, I'm not writing any JavaScript code to wire this stuff up. I'm literally just declaring a template, looping over the data, and stamping out Google Map Marker children. And of course, we're data binding that latitude and longitude property to the particular cell that we're interested in. So again, it's all super declarative, and the surface area is just using HTML attributes. So that's the entirety of the application. If somebody wants to use this, it's just a matter of bringing in PlatformJS, right? These are the polyfills that actually allow you to use this stuff in browsers that don't support the native APIs. Check. You want to declare the Google Maps sheet as an HTML import. That's going to bring in the element we just created. Check. The last thing you want to do is just declare the Map Sheets tag on your page. And of course, what people get is this beautiful map, marker data, all powered by Google Spreadsheets. We didn't write any code to do it. We used Polymer web components. That's the bee's knees. So if you want to see a live demo of this, go check it out. It's at googlewebcomponents.github.io. We have this demo as well as a ton of other demos for all the other components we've created. So that's a small taste, just a small taste of what Polymer and web components can do. I really think web components are going to lock a fundamentally new way to program for the web. You've already seen it's productive, it's declarative, it's reusable, and you can vastly reduce the amount of code you write as a front-end developer. That's really, really awesome. So if you want to know more about creating applications using Polymer, do check out Rob Dotson's video and Eddie Osmani's video. These are a couple of stellar guys with some really, really great content. Check us out on polymer-project.org. This is our website, powered by Polymer, of course. And follow us on Twitter at Polymer. You can also feel free to hit me up anytime, ask questions. I'm always on Twitter. I'm on Google+. Oh yeah, one last thing. Go componentize the web, guys. Thanks for watching.